Chris DiGirolamo from Maggiano, DiGirolamo and Lizzi, here to talk about winter auto preparedness. Living in the Northeast, we know that weather conditions change on a dime. The way to make sure that you don't wind up in an uncomfortable or dangerous condition is to always be prepared, and most especially to be prepared for the unexpected. What I suggest, the first thing you do is when the winter months begin, sometime right after Thanksgiving, bring your car into a local auto shop or a dealership and make sure all of your fluids are checked. Make sure they check your transmission fluid, your brake fluid, even your antifreeze. Have them check the battery terminals in the car to make sure that your battery's running at full charge. Make sure they replace your auto windshield wiper fluid and make sure that it's an antifreeze type winter wash fluid. Make sure that you check the tires and that you have proper tread. If you don't have proper tread, replace your tires with either all season or winter stud tires, depending on the elevation where you live. Most importantly, make sure you have certain things with you. Make sure you have an LED light. Make sure that that light is with you and that there's batteries in it so that it's there when you need it. Make sure you have, in addition, outdoor car issues like a proper scraper that you can use when the temperature drops and there's precipitation. You always want to be prepared to have something to scrape off the windshield. When it's not quite as icy, you want to have a really good winter broom to make sure you can brush off any light snow or precipitation from the windshield of the car.
And don't forget, everybody should have a complete car kit with them at all times.
Zach, that's a great idea. Every car kit should have a minimum of specific items. For example, you should always have a pair of gloves. You never know if you're going to have a very hot or cold surface you have to deal with, or if you have leaky fluids you have to deal with. Having a pair of gloves is essential. You also need to have within your car kit a great tool kit. Specifically, this one has what's very important, which is the tire pressure gauge that allows you to find out whether you have too much or too little air in your tires. That's a big help when you're facing a dangerous condition. Most importantly, a good pair of jumper cables. This kit actually has an instructional diagram here which shows you how to install the jumper cables on each car in case you don't know how to do that. Finally, I always like having just a little note here. You could ask for emergency help, call the police. It's great to have this handy in your car.
You should always have a good first aid kit.
That's a great point, Dad. And they're really easy to find, too.
Sure. In fact, a kit like this, you can get at a CVS, local Rite Aid, anything like that. Kits usually come complete with some antiseptic, alcohol wipes, bandages, and some sort of an antibacterial.
I hope you find this video helpful. And remember,
always be prepared for the unexpected.